Leader, was tonight's vote somewhat expected? I mean, we'd seen this kind of be held up on the House.
Well, yes, it was somewhat expected. I mean, obviously, the Democrats have the majority, and it was their proposal that was stacked up against ours, and we're in the minority, so I can't say the outcome was unexpected.
Chairman Raul, when he was presenting his plan, frequently referenced the 2008 action. I'm curious, had that been called in 2008 in the Senate, how do you think it would have fared?
Honestly, I don't know, but I think that to continue to go backwards doesn't make a lot of sense. I think we all learn from different proposals that have come along in past times, and we try to put them all together and come up with the best proposal going forward. So I think what we had today, in my view, was a better proposal than what had been proposed in 2008.
Does the League of Women Voters, I mean, there was some discussion tonight about relaying some amendments on.
Obviously, with the citizens' initiative, it can't be amended because the signatures are out there. My amendment clearly replicates the Fair Map Amendment. However, there was a lot of discussion about improving it with respect to the minority voting rights, and certainly we would be open to doing that. But again, the core difference is between whether incumbents draw the map that ultimately protects themselves or whether an independent commission draws the map. That's really the difference.
But, you know, as you said, the amendment that you've proposed is identical to the Citizens Initiative. I mean, you said that the Citizens Initiative, I mean, you can't really go back and amend that. What about amending your proposal?
Oh, you can definitely amend my proposal. That would not be a problem, and as I indicated in there, certainly with respect to the minority voting protections, we would be interested in making it as strong as possible.
The issue of who draws the map seems to be the sticking point. Neither party wants to meet in the middle on that,
exactly.
It seems. There isn't a lot of time left. Do you see this as showing that maybe nothing's going to come out of this?
Well, there certainly is still enough time if there were consensus around the idea that an independent commission ought to draw the map, but clearly that is a sticking point.
So that isn't happening. I mean, are you concerned that no reform is going to come out of this process?
Well, it's certainly possible that we'll have a vote on this. I'm probably we'll have a vote on it, and it will come out along partisan lines, reflecting the two parties' interest in how the map is drawn. The Republicans on the one hand wanting to see an independent commission, the Democrats on the other wanting to see the incumbents draw the map.
So did you see any benefit to having this? I mean, we all said, I bet the Democrat proposal is going to be the one that wins.
Well, I think, you know, it was useful in terms of educating the public and shining a little light on what's really going on here.
And that is
making it look like we have reform when we really don't have reform. And what we will end up with is a system whereby the majority party or whoever we're getting away from the coin flip, but they will draw the map to protect themselves.
Do you get what the Democrats' issue is with the language in your bill on the minority stuff? Like, why is there so superior? What are they saying?
I mean, there's different ways to approach that. We do think that the language in the Fair Map Amendment, both what's out there on the street now being circulated by the League of Women Voters and what's in my proposal, does protect minority rights. But if there are additional things that they'd like to see included, then we'll certainly be willing to do it. That does not seem to be the sticking point, though. Although a lot of time was spent, I think, wasted on that discussion because there was agreement, it was really a red herring.
So is it just a matter of adding in or reworking language?
Yeah, it could be amended, or you know, we've got plenty of time left in the legislative session to change it.
But you don't think that's really the issue?
It's clearly not the issue, no. The issue is who draws the lines.
Given that your amendment has been out there since January, something like that, and you know, Chairman Raul introduced his last week, you've got all these organizations endorsing your amendment. Does having that extra time give you the edge, you know, to kind of get people like all the former reform commissioners, Cindy Canary?
Democrats and Republicans all live by the same calendar. I mean, Senator Raul could have introduced his amendment at any time. You know, there was a lot of discussion that we hadn't changed ours. They didn't introduce something until just recently. So I don't think that is an issue.
Thank you, ladies.